Today I'll be talking about digital opportunities. When you talk about digital opportunities, you are talking of opportunities in the digital world. But before I speak about it, the first assignment I have today is that of mentality switch. That is, if you check this place, you discover that there is a change going on here. This man, someone is working on his mentality. Someone is trying to help to remove something from there and impute something else. And what is that person trying to do? That person is trying to say, okay, what do you have that is wrong? The myth. Let me remove the myth and let me put the facts. Are we getting it? That's what this person is trying to do here. And the same thing is similar here. You see that everything we believe at one point or the other, everything we have ever believed is usually from what we have grown with, what we have learned, what we have seen, anyhow, anything we believe. So my duty today is to work on your view as far as the digital world is concerned. My duty today is to ensure that what you believe that is wrong about the digital world is taken care of and the right thing is added up to you. That's my duty. My duty is to ensure that you have the right perspective about the digital world. And my duty is to make sure that you understand what digitalization is and you lock on into the opportunities that are available to you in the digital world. And how am I going to start? I'm going to start that by defining exactly what is digitalization. Now, digitalization is the new normal. Of course, you know that before COVID-19, we add the old normal. We add our normal life. We add everything. Everything is physical. Everything is analog. Though in advanced countries, the issue has changed. The old normal is when you will tell your children, oh, please, don't take your phone into class. That's the old normal. You understand? The old normal is when everybody will have to go to church and you sit down and, of course, you must see a physical pastor, you must be in the physical church before anything can be done. You go to the physical mosque, you must see a physical imam, and you have to appear there before anything can be done. All this make up the old normal. The old normal in terms of education, in terms of religion, in terms of even transaction. If you want to buy anything, everything has to be physical, you understand? But in the new normal, there is a change. And what's the new normal in this age? This post-COVID new normal is digitalization. The new normal is the digital world. The new normal is it has gone beyond what we used to do. It's no more the analog. It's no more the physical. It's now the new normal. It's now digitalization. And that is why you realize that digitalization is not something anybody can hide from because it is the new normal, because it's the new way to go, because it's the only thing that is happening that we can that we can invest into. And that's the only place and the only method through which we can promote ourselves and move to higher level. Apart from that, what's digitalization? Digitalization, of course, is the conversion of text, of pictures, of sound into a digital form. All the texts you have, your books, your certificate, everything, your materials, all those things you have been doing with analog method, it's now going to be converted into digital form. Then that can be processed by a computer system. That's digitalization. If you look at what digitalization is, it converts assets to a digital format. All your assets, everything you have, your will, your materials, your landed properties, everything, all the materials you have, all the assets you have, all your belongings will now be converted to digital format. And it makes it easier to store, to share, to manage, and to analyze data. You discover that some people will say, oh, I'm working on my PhD, I want to do this, I want to do that, I just completed my master's, I want to go further. So I have some cases, I have some briefs. You know, we have different category of people in class today. We have lawyers, we have surveyors, we have pastors, and then we have some students, very few. Are you getting it? And of course, we have researchers. We have librarians in the class today, and it's a very good opportunity to be together. So you discover that all your assets, everything that the digitalization is converting into a digital format, a format that is easy to manage, easy to share. And those are part of the things we look at in terms of defining digitalization. Digitalization, of course, is a shift from physical into the digital or online format. That's something I'm going to explain. It's a shift. Now, I want to begin to discover that when we are talking of digitalization, you know, I'm not saying digitalization is for you to be computer literate. No, it is a shift from the physical into the digital or online form. Now, I think you need to get something very clear here. You are moving in digitalization. There is need for a shift. There is need for a movement. There is need for a conversion. It's a shift from the physical world into the digital world. That's digitalization. Digitalization is something that makes you everything you have been doing before with analog. Everything you have been doing before in the digital, in the physical world, everything you have been doing before in your own way. All these things now are going to change. All these things now are getting transformed. All these things now are moving from the physical. Okay. So you have it from the physical world to the digital world. And that's something very key. That's something very germane. What is important about it is you are moving from physical to digital. Please follow this. Because the next explanation is going to be premised on this one. There is a move from the physical to the digital. Now, it has nothing to do with age. It has nothing to do with education. The fact is, the world has moved from physical to digital. There's nothing you can do about it. The world has moved. The era of come and submit your paper, submit this, submit that, is gone. It's a general movement. It's a general advancement from the physical world to the digital world. What is digitalization? Now, based on that conversion, based on that movement, I can now explain to you that digitalization provides a platform to convey your content to the countries. Am I communicating now? There's something for me to explain to you here. Digitalization is the one that gives you a platform. It gives you the basis. It gives you the premises to convert your content, to convey your content, what you carry to the countries. Now, this is where the first error is going to be corrected. Digitalization is talking about what you carry, what you have on the inside of you. Digitalization is going to be converting your content, your carriage, what is on the inside of you will now be conveyed to the countries, which implies that it is what you have that is now is no more limited, so it's no more limited within the container of your locality. It's no more limited within the container of your area. You know, most of us are stars. Most of us, you are a known lawyer, you are a known lecturer, you are a PhD holder, they know you in your school, you are a surveyor and you are known. But where are you known? You are only known within that container. That's your area. You have been limited. You understand? Digitalization now is going to convey what you carry, convey your content to the countries. The countries. You see, at times by the time you do some things in your area, the people that should be appreciating you, they will look at you. They don't really understand. They have one or two complaints because they have understood you, because they know your life. They have one or two complaints about you. Don't worry. Digitalization has come to solve that problem. There is someone, you're in Nigeria here, there is someone in France who needs your content. How will that person get you? Digitalization. Are you seeing the change now? Are you seeing the swap? There is someone in Germany who needs your content. You know, I've said this times and again, in this particular class, we don't have any international candidate. In the past classes that we have had people from Canada, people from France, we have had people from Dubai, we have had people from America registering for this class. And that is because of the platform provided by digitalization. And that platform is so easy. You know what the platform has done? It has helped me to convey my content to the countries. That's what digitalization does. Your ability to write, your ability to speak, your ability to think, what you carry on the inside of you, your ability to do one thing or the other, which has been limited over the years to your locality. Digitalization will blow it open. Digitalization will take it to the countries. What digitalization does is to provide you a platform to convey your content to the countries. Are you seeing it? Very simple. It conveys your content to the countries. Now, it doesn't stop there. What does digitalization do? It provides a platform to promote your potentials to the people. Are you seeing that now? What your potentials are, your peculiarities, your area of specialty, the things that are good about you, the things that are special about you, that a lot of people should benefit from. Of course, those within your locality, they know you. Those within your area. You know, I remember Triamine. The last class we had, we trained some magistrates, and some of them, wow, very popular in their state, very well known. But by the time we got to the digital world, and we started checking what digital footprint is, they are nowhere to be found. You know what would be very funny to you? We had one very strong person. If I mention the name, every one of you in this class, you know this person I'm talking about. But funny enough, despite the popularity in Nigeria, despite the popularity in some countries in Africa, this person, she still did not have the digital presence she was supposed to have. Then some of them that even had gone through the training in the past, we have some that are musicians, we have some that are designers, that the challenge they had was that they don't understand the principle of digitalization, which we'll be learning because of this program. And because of that, some of them have even had people using their names wrongly without their knowledge because they don't understand digitalization. You need to read their comments. And they will say, wow, so this is how it is. We have trained some professors like that as well. So what does digitalization do? It promotes your potentials to the people. Those potentials you carry. When we talk about the people, I'm not talking about those who know you. I'm not talking about those who have access to you. I'm not talking about those within your locality. I'm talking about those who don't know anything about you at all. But these potentials, they need. Do you know something very funny? The people that are ready to really pay for your potentials, you won't believe, maybe they have not even spoken with you. Maybe they have not even seen you before. I mean, some of them are in France. Some of them are in America. Some of them are in Cote d'Ivoire. Some of them are in Ghana. You see, and these people, the only way they can meet you, the only platform they can meet you is the platform provided by digitalization. And that is why digitalization today is of great and peculiar importance. It does not stop there. It brings before, it brings out digitalization. It brings out the ability and the skills in the person. A lot of you carry a lot of skills, especially writing skills. But you have not, all you have been doing is you go on WhatsApp, you write. Let me tell you one thing. When we talk about digitalization, everything you write on WhatsApp is irrelevant. It's not part of digitalization. Digitalization has nothing to do with computer literacy. No. It has gone beyond that. Digitalization is going to bring out the ability in you, the skills in you. It, however, has a limitation. What is the limitation? It cannot promote that which is lacking in you. Are you saying that? You have something lacking in you. You have something that is your limitation. Digitalization cannot promote it. Do you understand? That is the limitation. That's the funny aspect of it. Digitalization cannot promote that which is lacking in you. That is why we keep telling people when we warn them about digitalization, that if you are coming to the digital world, make sure you are carrying something. You now begin to realize that digitalization has little or nothing to do about computer literacy. No, not at all. Digitalization has a lot to do about your own life. Digitalization has a lot to do about your own personality. That's what digitalization is after. It showcases mental capacity, but it cannot fill the gap of mental deficiency. Oh, what's your mental capacity? Digitalization will showcase it. When it is high, you'll be rated. That's how it goes. When it is high, digitalization will rate you. I always say something very funny. Google is watching you. Google is not only watching you, Google is rating you. That's digitalization. Digitalization promotes your mental capacity. What you are, if you sell it to the world, your mental capacity. Now you begin to discover that what is it, what is most important in the digital world is mental capacity. Do you understand? But there's something digitalization cannot do. It cannot fill the gap of your mental deficiency. What you don't know, what you lack. You understand? Digitalization will only show you that, look, this, as far as this issue is concerned, this person is this fool. This person has gone this far. I'm going to talk more about that area. It cannot be a cover up for inadequacies. No, not at all. Not at all. Digitalization can never be a cover up for inadequacies. It can't. And apart from that, you also need to understand that when we talk about digitalization, it's not going to cover you if you lack anything. And that is why you must understand what you are doing. If you are going to matter in the digital world, you must understand what you are doing. You must know what you are doing, and you must do it very well. You must understand what you are doing, and you must be able to push it, present it, and do what, and you must be able to support it. That's why we talk about digitalization. It says that you cannot give what you don't have. So parents that are in the house today, some of us are elderly, in course of discussing with one or two, three of you, I've had you telling me, oh, sir, that is meant for my children. No, it's not meant for your children. It's meant for you. You know, I was talking to someone, and the person said, look, as I am now, with where I am, I'm a prof. Even one of my children, the prof, I don't say prof, you relax, don't disturb yourself. As a professor, you, by the time you go through the class, you will discover that digitalization is meant for you, even much more important than those children. You are going to see as you move on. So you cannot give what you don't have. Some of the things that we are talking of that are needed in the digital world, these children don't have it. They have where they belong, but they don't have those things. Do you understand? So that is why we say that in this time, what we say, nemo dat quod non habet. That's what we call it in French. I mean, in Latin. And that's a common word for lawyers. You cannot give what you don't have. Once you lack it, you can't give it. And in the digital world, what it does is to promote what you have. Now look at this, that dramatic expression of digitalization. This is telling you what digitalization is and what it does to the people. Can you see this young man? You want to know what digitalization is? We are going inside that hole. That is the most important thing. When someone asks me, I don't have a computer, I answered, you don't need a computer. All you need is your phone. That is everything you need. You don't need a computer, you only need your phone. You are going inside. You remember what we used to tell our students? We tell them not to bring phone to class. What has happened now? Class has gone into the phone. And we tell people, don't bring phone to church, respect God. Now church has gone into the phone. Everything we have been complaining about, put off your phone, put off this. We are not putting off the phone again. We are not putting off the class. Some of you have another class now. You are putting off. You are putting off class, but your phone is always with you. You see the importance. You are going inside that phone. That is digitalization. Even if you understand that I can stop the class, you are going inside the phone. It is you going into the phone. That's digitalization. Digitalization, you are going into the phone. Now, what are you going to do there? You are going online. You are going onto the internet. You are going to the world. You are going to be presented to the world without walls. Digitalization, it removes walls. It removes the container. It releases you to the countries. It releases you to the people. That's what digitalization does. Look at this young boy. It's all his mind is on that system. That's digitalization. Digitalization, you don't have online community. Everything is online. You have digital friends. You have digital memos. You have digital immortality. You have digital footprint. Everything about digitalization is just saying you going deep. Into the phone. You going deep. You are soaking yourself into that phone. You are getting deep into that phone. There is no excuse. There is no saying. There is no stopping. You understand? You are getting into the phone, and that's digitalization. That doesn't stop there. What exactly is digitalization? Let's look at the future of digitalization. One, it is universal. It will remove every limitation. All the issue of, you can't be national again, you become international. You won't even stop at being international, you become global. If you want to become globalized, then you have to be digitalized. And that is, it covers the world without boundaries. Are you hearing me, says a man? If you want to become globalized, you become digitalized. Once you are digitalized, you are globalized. The issue now is the globe. The globe is not at your fingertips. The globe is at your palm. You can hold the globe just so easily. Digitalization covers the world without boundary. Every boundary will now be removed. Every boundary will now be removed. You understand? The world without boundaries is going to have endless possibilities. Now, are you getting something? All the limitations. Let me tell you some of you that are working. Oh, I'm a surveyor. Like my very good sister was a surveyor here. I'm a surveyor. And you look at yourself. You want to work for people. But all the people you have been working for are just within your jurisdiction. You know what is going to deliver you? It's digitalization. It's going to take you from that state where you are, not only to Nigeria, but to everywhere. Do you understand? That's digitalization. Apart from that, it increases your relevancy. And what's your relevancy? And once your relevancy increases, it increases everything about you. Are you getting it now? So when you talk about the futures of digitalization, he's saying you cover the world without boundaries and one endless possibility. Now let me tell you this. In the course of this training, you know, I have trained some people that even my humble self was like, wow, is it possible? How did you hear about me? Can you imagine someone calling you and telling you, I want to register for 10 people or what have you? Then you begin to wonder, how did you hear about me? It's not only like that. There are some people that by the time they called and they sent in their money, I was like, sorry, excuse me. Going by their surname, which I will not mention it anyway, going by their surname, it shows that they are linked to maybe the presidency or wherever. And it was confirmed. I said, wow, this is serious. How did I get to meet these people? I don't know them before. It's just digitalization, endless possibilities. Oh, the caliber of people you will meet, the caliber of people that will call you. I received a call from Bayelsa just yesterday. And the person called me and said, I saw your poster and I'm interested. And the person was talking to me, said, when I got to the VC of Bayelsa University, I was still trying to crack my head. Where on earth I know the VC of Bayelsa University? He said, the VC recommended you to me. I was just wondering, you understand what I'm saying? Endless possibilities. The kind of assignments you will receive, the kind of corporate bodies that will call you, the kind of support you will get through digitalization is endless. And that is why you must follow the principles. It has principles, and the principle is not computer literacy. You are going to be seeing it. That is why this first class, this introductory class, will teach you about the principles and what and the opportunities of digitalization. That's what we are treating now. And that's part of what you need to understand fully. Another future of digitalization is that it is procedural. Please get it very clear. It is procedural. It must follow a procedure. That is why you are in class today. Anybody can pick his or her phone and use her phone, but it goes beyond that. It requires training. There are laid down rules. For example, SEO, SELPS. These are information you will understand, and it will help you as you grow in the digital world. Or it requires specialization. You must create a niche. I'm happy I have a brother and a friend in the house who has created a niche. I've always been opportune to have such people in the class at one time or the other. You must create a niche. You must have a niche. I mean, how do you have a niche? What do you mean by a niche? You must create a niche. You must have an understanding of what a niche looks like. And that is the reason. That is the basis that you are going to have that will make you stand your ground. You must have a niche. Well, a niche is your peculiarity, your specialty. In the digital world, if you don't have a niche, you cannot have a voice. Do you want to have a voice? You must have a niche. You must have a niche in the digital world. What's your niche? What's your peculiarity? If you see, I gave you an assignment, a pre-class activity, asking you for your strength. You know what I wanted to get out? I wanted to help you to get out your niche, your peculiarity, your specialty, your area of comfort. You understand? You need to create a niche. Get that very clear. In the digital world, you must create a niche. You must have a special area where you are going to build on. We have some of you that are academicians. I must not leave you out of the case. When you're an academician, apart from you being in a department, you must have an area. Take, for example, the doctor in our midst. You see, you have an area that is your own. That area is your niche. There's a question. If you go online, if we check you in the world, how rated are you in the area that you call your niche? That is the function of digitalization, is to promote that. But if you don't have a niche, digitalization has nothing to promote. If you don't have a niche, you don't have a peculiarity, you don't have a specialty, you don't have where you belong, you don't have your area of specialty, area of respect. Once you don't have it, then digitalization has nothing to give to you. Then digitalization has nothing to provide for you. And that's why you must understand this very clearly, that you need a niche. Now, another thing is about digitalization. You need to think value, not activities. Are you with me? You think value, you talk value. Digitalization deal with value. The idea of 30 days make one pay is going off so fast, is going off so quickly. 30 days make one pay is giving way to value. People, some people, of course, after losing their job, some will still lose their job the more, whereas some will get more value. Do you understand? You know what people want to pay for now? They want to give you something to do and they pay you. That's what they are after. Nobody's interested in, hey, look, these are the activities. And you go to work, you come back. There is nothing like I'm going to work. You can sit at home and make what people who are going to the office every day cannot make. That's digitalization. Digitalization is not saying go from one place to the other. Digitalization is saying sit in your house. Begin to make your money based on value. There are some companies, all they want you to do is to write for them. Some, they want you to help them edit. There are different things. They will give you assignments. Once you complete the assignment, they pay you. Digitalization. That's what we are talking about. It doesn't stop there. Physical disability is no more the limitation in the digital world. What is limitation now is mental disability. Are you getting what we are saying? What's the limitation? If I'm going to ask you a question, what is the most important tool in digitalization? Who can tell me? It's your intelligence. It's your mental capacity. That's the most important tool. The most important tool in digitalization is not computer literacy, no. It's your mental capacity. And that's going to be a classwork for you. I wish to have an answer from everybody. If you are there behind your system, behind your phone, can you just give me an answer? What's the most important tool in the world of digitalization? I want to read from you. Quickly type it, let me see your answers. What's the most important tool in the world of digitalization? What's the most important tool? Now we have been learning it. What do you think is the most important? What do you think is, what is germane? What can you not do without? Yes, let me read from you. What's the most important tool in the world of digitalization? We need to hear from you. Quickly, let me be sure you are in class. I want to read from everybody in class. Yes, let me see you are in class. Come on, type something. Let me see. I'm waiting for you. Yes, I can see some of you are typing. I'm waiting. I've not been able to see anyone. I'm waiting for you. The most important tool in the world of digitalization. The most important tool. Yes, someone has dropped the message. Who is that? Oh, mental abilities. Thank you so much, Mutaru. Yeah, mental abilities. What's the most important tool in the world of digitalization? Everybody, I want to read from you. The most important tool. Because, of course, you have had some ideas before. You've had some myths. You before, but now you are learning something new. You are learning that no, it's not the way you think. It's not what you used to think. It's not. No, not at all. The most important thing in the world of that, let me hear from you. Thank you, mental capacity. I'm reading from another source now. I want to read from you. I want to read from you. I want to type it. What's the most important tool in the world of digitalization? What can you not do without? Yes, thank you so much, my dog. It's mental capacity. That's the most important. I want to read from others. The most important tool is your mental capacity. is what you have to deliver, is the content you carry, is the potential within you. That's the most important. That is the most important, and that is what is most needed. And having known that, you now have to know what you are going to pursue. You remember what I told you? You cannot give what you don't have. So your first assignment in today's class is to think deep and begin to ask yourself, what exactly do I want to give? Is to begin to ask yourself, what exactly do I want to give? Let me get a bit personal. Look at my friend in the house. Okay, you discover that you have been in drama, you have been acting and acting, but there's a question that people want to learn from you. The principle of acting. How many of it have you written? How many has been written? How many has been given to the world? How many have you given to the younger generation? That's what this transition is all about. This transition is saying, don't carry all these gifts away. Bring them out. Put them out there. You have the mental capacity. You have the content. The direction is then you will carry those content. You carry the capacity. You place it there. Then they will call you. They'll call you from France. They'll call you from Germany. They'll call you from Cote d'Ivoire. They'll call you from Nigeria. And they'll say, that thing you have written, that thing you have placed, is not the acting of the film alone. That ability, that diligence, that discipline. A lot of young actors, how come they fail? Why didn't you fail in your acting career? That principle they want to read from you. And that's digitalization. That's what digitalization is all about. Zainab, I've not read anything from you. Valerie, I've not seen you typing anything. Clinton, I've not seen anything from you. Auditor, I've not seen anything from you. Please, I'm expecting, it's a classwork, I'm still waiting for you. So you understand? So that is something you have to get. What else is important? Another thing that is important in the digital world is originality. No room for copycat. All those, you copy this, you copy that. It does not work in the digital world. In the physical world, you can copy anybody. In the digital world, you cannot copy. What I'm doing now is my niche, is my area. If you ask me to talk about sport, I may not know about it. But this one I'm talking about, no. I know it in and out. That's my niche. That's my area. That's the value I'm adding to you. And there is no room for copycat. You don't copy anybody. The digital world will not allow it. No room for copycats. No room. No, not at all. So what the digital world expects is that you go forth and towards and you display that which you carry. That's the platform that is being provided for you in the digital world. Now let's move on. What are the myths about digitalization? The myth about digitalization, I'm explaining them to you. One, they say you must be computer literate. No, not at all. Not at all. You don't need computer literacy. Forget it. If you add it, it's an addition. You will see where it's applicable very shortly as we move on. Computer literacy is not a criteria for digitalization. No. People don't get that. There are two different things. Apart from that, what is next? Another thing that is next is that people say it's for youth. No. It's not meant for youth. From what I've been explaining now, is it meant for youth? How many youths carry the content that they want to deliver there? It's not meant for youth. That's what I always tell people. If they want to register anybody who's in secondary school, I'll tell them, don't bring them in. People in the from tertiary institution and above, it's not a primary school pupil. Oh, you say the boy is very good. He uses the when he handles the computer, that's not what we are talking about. It goes beyond that. Digitalization is those ones, they have their name. You are going to read about them very shortly. If someone says it's free, it's not free. Anytime you see, when we get to digital footprint, you will understand it's not free. When you see someone telling you there's a free program and they ask you to leave your email, you are paying through something else. Are you getting it now? Nothing is free in the digital world. It is cheap, yes, but it is not free. Oh, some people say it gives quick money. No, it doesn't. It doesn't give quick money, not at all. It will give you money, but not quick money. These are facts you need to understand. It will give you money, but it will not give you quick money. Okay, I'm reading from someone. Someone is saying flexibility. Valerie, God bless you. I love that. Flexibility. You understand? So it gives money, but not quick money. These are things you need to understand. Now, it doesn't stop there. Look at the facts about digitalization. I'm trying to be a bit fast because of your time. Now, it requires personal discovery. If you have not discovered yourself, you cannot last in the digital world. It requires personal discovery. You must discover yourself. You are an actor, you are a writer, you are a speaker. Discover yourself. You are an organizer. Discover yourself. You are a researcher. Discover yourself. The digital world requires personal discovery because for you to last, in the digital world. You need continuity, you need consistency, and that will come only through personal discovery. You must discover yourself. You must know, who am I? You must be able to answer that question without any problem, because that is the basis of your success in the digital world. It requires personal discovery. Then your height depends on the depth of your mental capacity. When we talk about your height, how far you go. When we talk about your height, how high you go in the digital world, it depends on your mental capacity. That is why, as we are in class now, you discover that the most experienced is going to be the one who will go highest in the digital world. That is how it goes. Imagine what a professor will write. Okay, look at my friend here now. Imagine what he's going to write about drama and someone who has just started acting. It's going to be different. That's what we talk about digitalization. Digitalization, the eye depends on your mental capacity. Imagine what a professor will write and a graduate from BSc. The gap is so wide. The height you go depends on your mental capacity. Are you people now saying, adults in the house, senior men in the house, senior women in the house, are you seeing now that digitalization is not meant for children at all? It's meant for adults. It's meant for the grown-up ones. It's meant for right from the university, well, from the Polytechnic, College of Education, where you have something to hide. That is where digitalization starts from. Another issue is it must be purpose-oriented. It must have a purpose. It must have a purpose. You cannot just be digital for nothing. Are you there for money? Are you there for relevance? The truth is you are going to get money, but it's until you have relevance. You know, people are paying me today. Why are they paying me? They are paying me because they know me over the years. I have built integrity. I told you, by the grace of God, we have trained professors, we have trained doctors, we have trained magistrates, we have trained judges. And you are not getting what I'm saying. I've trained over 20 lawyers that have come one point or the other. These people, how come? It's because of the trust. Over the years, you must have a purpose. Everything you want to do in the digital world, are you going there for relevance? Once you have relevance, you have money. Let me tell you what relevance is. Look at someone like Linda Ikeja that we talk about. She has relevance, and that's why she's having money. Do you understand? But some of us have relevance. We have not been getting the money because we have not maximized our presence in the digital world. By the time we are done with this, I'm telling you that, okay, look at us now. Someone has built, okay, you have built over the years. You know how many years you have spent? Barrister Kende, you are welcome, please. Sorry. So you understand, it must have a purpose. We have all these things. So by the time you look at yourself, you know the number of years you have spent in acting. Now the purpose you will have, because you already have relevance, now that relevance, how much of it has translated into money to you? The people, okay, let me give you an example of C. Ronaldo. You know what C. Ronaldo does? He has a digital presence. That digital presence is what he's selling. He's making more money from me than what football can give him. You will not believe. You're in the same category, you're at the same level, and that's what I'm going to promote you to get into. You understand? Because you discover that you already have it. You know, when Google sees people with relevance, what Google does is, your people, like, for example, if you're writing about drama and someone wants to advertise, the person will come to you, they will go to Google and pay Google. Google, we want to advertise this. Google will now look at your digital presence. When you have it, or I've checked, most of you don't have it yet. In fact, in this class, I still don't have anyone who has it. Well, by the time we are getting to class tomorrow and on Sunday, everything will be clear to you what we mean. Now, Google will now look at you. Google will now pay you. Google will now place it with you. So when anybody clicks on it, they will now begin to pay you. Can you imagine? For someone to click and you are paid, that's what happens in this world. Okay, you have reached this level. The question is, have you made that money? The answer is no, you have not made that money. And this opportunity is there for you. I'm excited you are here. you understand, the digital world. My baristas that are in the house, the question is, what have you, well, I know what you are doing in your area. You have been called to pass social number of years. You have been influential in education as a doctor for this number of years. There is a question, are you being paid internationally based on what you have achieved over the years? That's digitalization. It's only purpose-oriented. Now it requires traffic. Lecturer, can I speak to you here? Do you know that all your students make up traffic? Do you know what Google pays on? It's on traffic. Google will pay you on traffic. If all your students go to check you, Google does not know that they are your students. What Google knows is that people are always checking. And you have lecturers. 90% of Nigerian lecturers are not represented in the digital world. I'm saying it without apology. 95%, let me give you 5%. I've spoken to a lot. I've told you it's not computer literacy. By the time we are done with this program, but by this time on Sunday, you will be completely transformed when it comes to the digital world. You understand? Because it's not computer literacy. So a good number are computer literate, but when we talk of having digital presence, when we talk of digitalization, 90% of our lecturers are not in the digital world at all. And that is it. And they have this traffic. I will show you what traffic is. Oh, if you are a lawyer, all your clients, they make up your traffic. Can you imagine someone who is now a TV star? Can you imagine how much traffic you have? All your lovers, they are your traffic. But the question is, are you using them? Digitalization requires traffic. Now you discover how many fresh graduates will have the traffic that a professor will have. That's the question. How many fresh graduates we have the traffic that a star like you, okay, we have? How many fresh graduates we have the traffic that a judge we have, a magistrate we have? That's what we are talking about. So you see, it requires traffic. Most importantly, it requires patience. Oh, it requires, but you can't rush. You can't rush. Now that you are just starting in the digital world, don't say it's going to happen overnight. No, it won't happen overnight. It requires patience. You have to be patient. Let me be very fast because of our time. Now we have categories of digital people. Let me show you the categories here. Now you have categories of digital participants. We have basically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 categories. Digital masses, you know who they are. That is where the children fall. These digital masses, everyone in the universe, you know, it's just, the digital world is like a marketplace. Everybody goes there to buy one thing or the other. When they get there, they want to buy something or the other. You discover, oh, they are there. They are buying this. They are buying that. That's the digital world. You understand? In the digital world, they are buying one thing or the other. The people there, those are the digital masses. They are the ones that will download things. They play games. They listen to music. They form the digital masses. They don't make up the content. They don't make any money online. That is where all of you were before. We are now moving forward. Digital masses, this is where the youth belong. They don't need any training to do it. No. They don't need to attend this class. And some of them will say, I can do this. You know what they go to do? They watch film. They are on WhatsApp. That's all they do. We call them digital masses. And some of you who are not digital masses, you think those are the people that own the internet. They are not the ones. You understand? They are just digital masses. They are masses. Understand? They don't contribute anything. They are the ones that spend their money. They make no profit from the digital world. Now, are we moving on? Digital workers. That is where you belong now. These people, they are the ones that trade products and services in the digital world. They have digital presence and digital value. Are you getting it? They spend and earn. Look at it now. I'm spending also, and I'm earning from you. That's it. That's how it goes. In the digital world, the digital workers are the ones that will spend and they will earn. They will spend money, they will make money. They spend money, they make money. You see, they earn. But for them to earn, they will learn. And you know, the difference between earning and learning is the L. And that L means you have to labor. You have to do something. And you get in it now. So in the digital world, the digital masses, you discover that the digital masses, the digital workers, they spend and earn. They require training to maximize their earnings. They require training to maximize their earnings. They require, you have to get this fact. they require training to maximize their earnings. Now, it doesn't stop there. Everyone in this class, it qualifies to be the category of digital workers. Everyone in this class qualifies to be in the earning of digital workers. And that's why you have to brush up. Now that you are here, you have decided to be part of this program, you must understand the principles and follow it. Now, digital vendors, these people, well, of course, they don't even know, need to know how to program. What they do is they look for a problem, they go to the place, the people, I can imagine, let's do this for your company, for your school. Like now that all schools are going online, they can promote, they can propose a special program for the school. When they propose it, they will now come to people like us who are the digital developers. The digital developers will be the one to those, that is where computer literacy is needed. Programming. Digital developers. You see that now. Digital developers, that's where computer literacy is needed. Are you getting it now? And such people, what you do is by the time you look at them, you say, what is happening? These people, they are the ones that will now understand the programming level, how to design program. Now, I write program, I design website, design blog. Those are digital developers. It's not everybody that falls into that category. So digitalization, you have different categories. We want those we call innovators. They don't need to know anything. All they do is to have ideas. You understand? They have ideas. And you understand, and when you have such, you discover that these people will now be the ones to give ideas to people, and they are being paid. There is not common in Nigeria, but it is possible in the digital world. What else do we have? Now you see categories of people. We have three categories of digital masses, and they are the ones that create and fill up the digital gap. We have the digital natives, the children from age 0 to 29, they are digital natives. They are digital natives, they are children, they are youths. The problem they have is they misuse and abuse digitalization. But these people, if we train them, they can go into design and programming. They are the ones that need computers. Are you getting what I'm saying now? Then we have digital immigrants. This is where most of us belong. You and I, we are not, but when I was in the university, there was no phone. I would travel from Lagos to Obafemi University to confirm that the school has resumed. There was no phone. Digital immigrant. We learned it, you understand? And after learning, we are now applying it to our work. But the problem is that we underutilize it. Everybody who is a digital immigrant needs a blog and a website. Now, I'm catching you. If you don't have a blog, you don't have a website, you are not in the digital world. That's digitalization. If you don't have a blog, you don't have a website, you are not known in the digital world. You are not recognized. Are you getting it now? Then we have the digital aliens. Digital aliens, they are supposed to be immigrants, but they have decided that they won't learn anything about it. Old professors, it's wrong. Some will call it antichrist. We call them digital aliens. Now, the categories of digital of workers, unemployed people, if you are unemployed, I'm telling you, you don't need to look for a job with digitalization. If you learn programming and design and you become a developer, you discover that you don't need to look for a job. All you need to do is for you to move. Are you getting down? And for you to grow. And now by the time you look at career workers, you have a career and you have been doing something for 10 years, 20 years, you must have a blog. You are the ones that we are looking for. Career workers are content carriers. You are a lecturer, you are a career worker. You started somewhere, you want to be a professor. Hey, you're a career worker in that area. You must write. The world needs to hear from you. You are a career worker, you are a barrister, you are a career worker. In the next 10 years, you are not going to stop being a barrister. You will rather be growing in rank. Are you getting it? You want to, if you are a barrister or you have been taught to bar for 10 years, you will definitely have something to tell those of us who are just coming to join you. That's what we are talking about. You are a career worker. And that is why you must understand the power of digitalization and you must follow it. Career workers are content carriers. These content carriers must deliver their content. Or business owners, you must have a website. You don't have a choice. Advent of digitalization, it will give you presence. It will help your decision making. It will encourage innovation. It will improve your working condition. Apart from that, we now need to look at digital opportunities. I'm trying to rush because of time. One, you can have online full employment. Even if you are in school, you can be employed fully. Even as a student, you can be fully employed. And of course, you can have part-time employment as working class, because there are some people that all they will do is to give you some jobs. They will tell you to edit, they will tell you to look to it, and they will solve it. And of course, you can be sell online. Another thing is you can trade. Look at the training I'm offering now. And you imagine, okay, let me tell you, if you have a drama school, acting school, and people pay him online, and you begin to train them this way, you know, you make your money. You, that's it. That place you are seated now, that's where you will sit, and we just prepare it, KOK Drama School. We just prepare it, KND by Chambers. We just prepare it, you know, Adulogu Chambers. That's all we prepare. And you sit down there, you begin to teach them the principle of drama. You begin to teach them the principle of law. You begin to teach them the principle of research. You start based on different areas or specialty. You begin to teach them the principle of survey, online training, and they will pay you. They are ready to pay. And by the time you are there, you give them online certificate, and everything is good. E-consultancy, counseling, all these things can be done from your own. The social media marketing. Young boys in the house, young ladies in the house, you need to become SEO expert. These are things you can learn. You know that, look at the issue of voice over artists. Some of these people that act film, that you see cartoon plays, they're displays, they pay people who voice actions, who voice things. Maybe you are voicing music, you are voicing direction. You can be paid for that. Your voice can be trained, or maybe you have naturally good voice. All these things can give you money in the digital world. Let me show you something that is so funny. Look at what this boy has displayed. This is a very young boy. You know what? He has a blog, and on his blog, if you want to show video, you pay him 10,000. If he wants to help you get 500 followers, 3,000. Professor in the house, tell me, how many students do you lecture in a semester? Look at those students, they are over 1,000. Some of you have 1,100 level, 1,200 level. Can you imagine? And someone is collecting this amount just for helping you get those people to follow you online. And your students will follow you, but you have a presence. That's what we are talking about. This is how people have been making money in the digital world. I don't want to waste your time. It doesn't stop there. Targeting in the next 5 minutes that you land up. This expression, of course, how do you express yourself in the digital world? So you can use all these emojis, emoticons, voice note, and the rest. But what I'm going to talk about here is graphics. Graphics application on mobile phones. Of course, everybody in this class, you saw the graphics of this training. That poster you saw that brought you here to be part of this class, you will design it by this time on Sunday. You will design it easily. Anytime, I always tell my students, anytime anybody is celebrating birthday, you don't need to go and say happy birthday with the by right. No, you will say, you will design something for the person and you just throw it. That's digitalization. You represent it. You will do it with your phone. Within 10 minutes, you are done. Within 10 minutes, you are okay. Are you getting it? That digitalization. It doesn't stop there. So what are the other advantages? Because of our time, it's a digital platform for expression. What are the platforms? One, you have to think of the social media, email, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook. I'm going to give you this assignment. Another one is blog. If you go online, go and check this, www.dianshobowale.com. Please check this. This is important for you to check. It's going to form part of the assignment against tomorrow's class. Just check it. Read the blog and make a comment. I will read it. I will get to know. You go to this place, that is having a blog. That's having a presence in the digital world. I'll be explaining that to you tomorrow. Website for business, companies. You have a company, you have a chamber, you need a website. You cannot but have this. Graphics, of course, I've told you, you'll be learning this in the course of this class. Now, what else are we going to have? Apart from this, you see that, apart from this, now, there is something about digital worlds. How do you gain digital world? Digital world can be gained only by knowing your identity. What's your identity? What's your professional platform? Your identity, that's your name. Now, I have to explain something to you here. Some of you, of your email address, if your email address does not reflect your name, then something is wrong. Your email address must show your name. Your email address must reflect your name. Please, I want to say this very clearly. Your email address must always reflect your name. Your email address must always reflect your name. You see, if you have to be spelling your email address, that means you are missing something. Then when you talk about what's your name on Facebook, what's my email address? It's Shubowale Adedayo. Your email address should reflect your name. People should not find it difficult to pick your email address. It's not meant for you. It's meant for the users. Are you getting it? It's not meant for you. It's meant for the users. Understand this principle and follow it. Your email address should show your name. Then your professional platform, that's your education. Then whatever you are doing as your work, that's only what will feed you. Do you want to be wealthy? It's your potential. Your potential will make you wealthy. And that is where digitalization is coming to help you, to promote that thing you carry. Now, your skills will determine how high you go. That's the issue of mental capacity. And that's why you are in this class. By the time you are done now, by the time we are done on Sunday, from what you have seen now, you have discovered that digitalization, you have something to do in the digital world the moment you have something to offer. You have something to do in the digital world, the moment you have something to offer. That's the truth. There's no guessing about it. Now, if you look at this, another issue is you need to understand that you must grow your skills in that area. Please grow your skills. Please grow your skills. It's very, very important. Now, I'll be rounding up with the D's of digitalization. What are they? You discover the needs. You must discover your needs. What are the areas? If you want to maximize digitalization, let me tell you what made me to start this program. I have read, if you go online, you will hardly find anybody running a course on fundamentals of digitalization. What they will teach you is digital marketing. And when you start it, you won't understand. Because they will just be telling you some professional languages. Now, look at the way we have started. You have known that digitalization starts with you. You have known that. You are now thinking of, what am I going to sell to the world? You have understood that. Tomorrow when we move on, you will see that you will have become a different person. I will have checked you out. I'm going to talk to you about digital presence tomorrow. Now, there is the question. You must discover a need that you want to solve. After discovering the need, you design the solution. You understand? I discovered that the people that need digital move, all lecturers, all top-placed people, they need digitalization seriously. All of them. Fashion designers, baristas. A lot of people tell you, I don't have a chambers. I don't have money. What do you need chambers for in the digital world? You don't need the chambers. People will run after you without having a physical chambers. www.yourname.com is all we need. www.yourname.com is all we need. And that's what we are talking about, digitalization. You design the solution, then you develop the necessary skills. The moment the skills are developed, then you begin to demonstrate yourself. Brethren, that's all you do. Demonstrate yourself, then you distribute yourself. That's what I'm doing now. I'm distributing myself. I'm serving my community. I'm explaining to you this is what you need. You understand? That's all digitalization is all about. Don't rush yourself. Don't disturb yourself. Digitalization, you distribute yourself. You give yourself. And you see that you will definitely be celebrated. I thank you for giving me your time today. I thank you for being in this class. I believe you have learned one thing or the other. This is the very first class. We are going to continue tomorrow. By God's grace, we'll be continuing.